Hello, Miriam at the Bureau with your national weather forecast for tomorrow, Thursday the 12th of September. Taking a look at tomorrow's weather map, we can see that we've still got a west coast trough in play. It's hidden along the west coastline, but it's still there, interacting with this high pressure system over the Bight and continuing to produce cloud and areas of rain and thunderstorms across inland parts of Western Australia. But we have fairly active weather in the east as well. A cold front will move through today, then continue up the New South Wales coast during tomorrow, interacting with this trough through Queensland to produce showers and thunderstorms across much of northeast New South Wales and southeast Queensland through the day tomorrow. Storms in those areas may tend severe at times, so it'll be a good day to keep an eye on the radar and keep an eye on the Bureau's warnings page for any warnings that are issued. Let's take a closer look now, starting with Queensland. So, patchy morning fogs once again in the east, but the main focus is on the southeast and southern inland, where we're looking at showers and thunderstorms developing through the day. Now, severe storms are possible across parts of the Darling Downs, potentially producing damaging wind gusts, large hail, or locally heavy falls through the afternoon and evening. For Brisbane, we'll have a few showers developing, possible thunderstorm, a top of 26 degrees. For New South Wales, patchy showers through much of the eastern and central districts, with the chance of thunderstorms across those central parts of the state and in the northeast. There will be a risk of severe storms across parts of the northeast as well. Now, rainfall totals through New South Wales tomorrow will be fairly modest in most areas and a bit patchy. But across the northern coastlines, the northern tablelands and northwest slopes and plains, we might see some more moderate falls with storms through tomorrow. For Sydney, we're looking at a showery day, top of 20 degrees, with some cooler southerly winds moving in. For Canberra, showers a top of 17 degrees. Down to Victoria now. We're going to see showers in the east early, but they'll be clearing out as the day goes on, leaving us with mostly dry conditions by the afternoon. Cloud in the south, but sunnier conditions in the north. For Melbourne, it'll be a morning shower or two, top of 15 degrees. Down in Tasmania, a dry start there too, with a few showers moving across the west as the day goes on, but it won't be as wet, as cold, or as windy as what we've seen over the past few days. Hobart is looking at a partly cloudy top of 16 degrees tomorrow. For South Australia, there is a risk of some patchy morning frosts through parts of the agricultural districts, even pushing back towards the Flinders. But a mostly dry and sunny day will follow, a little bit cloudier in the southeast. Adelaide, the capital city, is heading for a sunny top of 19 degrees tomorrow. For Western Australia, dry and sunny weather across our western and southern districts, driven by that west coast trough. Perth is heading for a sunny top of 27 degrees. We will see patchy cloud, rain and isolated thunderstorms across those inland parts though, mainly impacting the southern interior tomorrow. Finally, for the Northern Territory, more cloud, showers and possible storms across the far southwest of the Lassiter District. And we can see the impact that's having on the temperatures too, with Uluru heading for a top of just 23 degrees. But it'll be much drier and warmer elsewhere across the state, especially pushing up into the north. We are looking at elevated fire dangers once again through the Darwin and Adelaide River fire weather district. Darwin itself heading for a sunny top of 36 degrees tomorrow. Now you can find the detailed forecasts for all your areas via the Bureau's website and the BOM social media. Have a great day and we'll catch you tomorrow.